Hi students, today we are going to see about transversal. A line that intersects two or more line at distinct point is called transversal. So you can see in this figure the L1, L2, L3 are the three lines. These three lines is intersect by the L4. Then the L4 is called transversal line. So let me go for an angle made by transversal. So here I'm considering the two lines L and M. And L and M is both the line intersect by the line P. So the line P is called a transversal line. So this transversal will made at 8 angles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This 8 angles we can name as an interior angles are 3, 4, 5, 6. The which inside the line L and M. And the exterior angles which lies in the outside. It is 1, 2 and 7, 8. 1, 2, 7, 8. And pairs of corresponding angles are 1 and 5 are corresponding angles, 2 and 6 are corresponding angles, 3 and 7 are corresponding angles, 4 and 8 are corresponding angles. Next, the pairs of alternate interior angles are 3 and 6 alternate and also in the interior, and 4 and 5 alternate and on the interior. The pairs of alternate exteriors are 1 and 8, both are in exterior and also in the alternate, 2 and 7. Next, pair of interior angle on same sides of the transversal. So in the transversal, pair of interior but on same side. Same side means 3 and 5, 4 and 6. So here we go for the notes that I will show here, as the corresponding angles can have a different vertices. Two corresponding angles will have a different vertices. And are on the same side of the transversal, it will be the same side, whether left, right, like that. Are in the corresponding position above or below or left or right relative to the two lines. So here I have shown the four corresponding angles. So 1 and 3 are in the corresponding angles. It has the different vertices and on the same side above and also on the left side. The same you can see that different vertices below and in the left side. Here also different vertices above and right side. Here also the different vertices below and right side. Clear? And while coming to the alternate interior angles, it also have a different vertices or on opposite sides of transversal and line between the two lines. You can see that it have a different vertices, and you can see that opposite of the transversal. This is the transversal line, right? So this is the transversal. 3 and 6 are in the opposite. Here also 4 and 5 are in the opposite. And also line between the two lines. The angle is between these two lines. Here is this angle is between these two lines, right? Same different vertices and opposite to the transversal. And next third is in between the two lines. So here we come for some special cases. Transversal cut two parallel lines. When a transversal cut two parallel lines, we have following intersecting relationship. So if the transversal line cuts any two parallel line, I am considering is this line L and M are parallel, and let the transversal be cut that parallel lines, we will be having some interesting relationship. The first relationship is each pair of corresponding angles are equal. We know the corresponding angles are 1 and 5, right? So they said it is equal. So that corresponding angles, angle 1 is equal to angle 5, and we know that 2 and 6 are corresponding, so angle 2 is equal to angle 6, and angle 3 and 7 will be equal, and finally the last 4 and 8 are equal. Clear? Since they are corresponding angles, this satisfies only when the transversal cuts the parallel line. We have to be very careful on this point. The next, each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. So alternate, which is the opposite to the transversal, and also in the interior are equal. So 3 and 6, angle 3 is equal to angle 6, and one more alternate interior is 4 and 5. So angle 4 is equal to angle 5. Clear? Next, each pair of interior angles on same side of transversal are supplementary. Supplementary we have learnt in the last class. If we add, we will be getting a 180. So here is interior on same side. So interior means in between these two lines, the same side is 3 and 5, So if we add an angle 3 plus angle 5, we will be getting it as a 180 degree. The same way another is 4 and 6. So angle 4 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree. These are the interesting relationship we got. And while solving the problem, be careful. It will be not in the same order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, how it is appeared in this problem. Just an example. This line can be, this number can be at the different positions also. We have to remember by the name like in a corresponding alternate interior same sides. So like these words only we have to remember it. So here we go for the problem. State the property that is used in each of the following statement. If A is parallel to B. So A is parallel to B. If it is given the parallel, then we can use the transversal relations also. Then angle 1 is equal to angle 5. They said angle 1 is equal to angle 5. So what relationships we are using here? Corresponding angles, right? So first one answer is, if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, each pair of corresponding, so it is 1 and 5 are corresponding, right? Angles are equal in measure, so it will be a equal. Clear? So next one, if angle 4 is equal to angle 6, they given angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Actually, it is satisfying like an alternate interior angle, right? Then A is parallel to B. Then this line A is parallel to angle B. Yes, this also satisfies, right? So it's look like in a transverse, right? When transversal cut two lines such that so pairs of alternate, this alternate we are talking about 4 and 6 is alternate interior, right? So alternate interior angles are equal, so the line have to be parallel. So we already know that only for the parallel line the three condition will be satisfying, right? So it said it is equal, then sure the A and B should be a parallel. And third one, if angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180, 4 and 5 are interior same side, it is also satisfying that condition, then A is parallel to B. If it is an anterior sides are supplementary, then sure it should be a parallel, right? So it is same as the second one, but here it is an interior on same side. So when a transversal cut two lines such that the pairs of interior angle on same side. Previously it was an interior alternate, it's the same side. Transversal are supplementary, then sure the line have to be a parallel. So here we go for the next problem. In the adjoining figure P is parallel to Q, find the unknown angle. So only one angle is given, 125, and it also given P is parallel to Q, then this line have to be a transversal. So we can use the condition and we can see. So one of the thing is given is a 125 degree. So 125 and E is like an linear pair, like just a straight line and this line cuts, right? So it's look like a linear pair. So 125 degree plus E is equal to 180 degree. Since it is a linear pair, we have to write the condition. By what condition we are writing it? So now we can find the angle E, right? So E is equal to 180 degree minus 125, and so the E is equal to 55 degree. We found what is the E. So and F should be also equal to E, since it is like in a vertically opposite angle. So F is equal to 55 degree, since it is vertically opposite to angle E, right? Then we can say that D is equal to 125, since it is a corresponding angles, right? So D is equal to 125 degree, since it is corresponding to angle 125 degree. So we know the D, then what will be the B? D and B are vertically opposite angle, right? So B is equal to 125 degrees since it is a vertically opposite to D, angle D, right? So we found D, only the rest A and C is there, and E and A are the corresponding angles, right? So therefore A is equal to E, E which is we have a 55 degree. So 55 degree we can say as corresponding to which one? E, right? And we know the A and C are the vertically opposite. So A is equal to C, A is equal to 55, so C is equal to 55 degrees since it is a vertically opposite to A, angle A, right? So this condition is very important to write how we have derived these things. Clear? So here we come for the next problem. Find the value of x in each of the following if L is parallel to M. So the given the two lines are parallel and the line T is transversal. So we can use the relationship that transversal and the parallel lines. We have to find the x. To find the x, we have to know this value or this value. Then only we can find. We can compare the alternate interior angles. Or if we know this value, we can say the same sides are supplementary. So this is very easy, right? Just vertically opposite angles also the same, 180 degrees. So same sides are supplementary, we can find that value, right? So 110 degree plus x is equal to 180. How we written? Since it is a supplementary angles. Clear? So we can find a x. So x is equal to 180 minus 110. So x is equal to 70 degrees. So this is possible only when they given the it is a parallel. So here we go for the next problem. In the given figure, the arms of two angles are parallel. So the BA is parallel to ED and BC is parallel to EF. So if this is parallel and BC is look like a transversal, if we considering BC and EF is parallel, we consider EDF is a transversal. So if angle ABC is given 70 degree, then find DGC. So this is also will be the 70 degree, right? Since these are the parallel lines and this cuts like in a transversal and it is like a corresponding angles, right? So here angle ABC is equal to angle DGC, right? Since it's a corresponding angles, so angle, that's what first thing we have to find, a DGC is equal to 70 degrees since we know that angle ABC is equal to 70 degrees. This is the answer for the first one. And what about the second one? We have to find DEF. DEF. We found already this is the 70 degree, right? So these two are the parallel line. They said arms are parallel. So this look like a transverse. So this angle will be equal to this angle since it is a corresponding. So angle DGC will be equal to angle DEF since a corresponding angles, right? So we need DEF, right? So angle DEF is equal to same 70 degree. Clear? So here we go for the next problem. So in the given figure below, decide whether L is parallel to M. So if it is L and it's like an two lines and L and L is N is transversal, intersect in the two parallel line, it should satisfy that relationship. If it doesn't satisfy any one of this, one of that relationship, then it is not a parallel. So it is given on the interior and the same side. We know the relationship interior and same side should be a supplementary. So it is given a 126 degree plus 44 degree, which is equal to 170 degree. It is not supplementary. 180 is the supplementary, right? So therefore, L is not parallel to M because sum of interior, it's the same side, right? Same side should be 180 degree to be a parallel. So it is not parallel since it is not a supplementary. It's not opposite, the same side, right? Same side should be a 180 degree to get be a parallel. So it is not a parallel. Clear? Thank you.